sometimes they may not be 100% true. So if you do want to find out, do some research on your own to double check. But for now, we will just use this. So sit back, relax, and enjoy. All right. If we have a plan B, our plan A is less likely to work. This is like, I've definitely known about this before. In fact, I think, if I remember correctly, I think Arnold Schwarzenegger had some sort of like motivational talk about plan A and plan B. Yeah, it's one of those things, like, if you, it's a little tricky, because, a lot of people, you know, they think, okay, you know, I have to plan this out. You know, if this doesn't work, then, you know, plan for this. If this doesn't work, plan for this. If this doesn't work, plan for this, kind of thing. But if you only have one plan, and you're like, this is a plan, this is what I'm gonna do, then it's more likely going to happen, as opposed to if you make backup plan. So if you just have your plan and it's like, I'm gonna do this, you'll have a better chance of actually getting that done, because it's always going to be in the back of your mind as, like, well, you know, even if this doesn't work, I have another plan. So fear can feel good if we're not really in danger. Let's see, so it says, not everyone loves scary movies. Before people do, there are a few theories as to why. I mean, when coming down to hormones, when you're watching a scary movie or walking through a haunted house, you get all the adrenaline, endorphins, and dopamine from your fight or flight response. But no matter how scared you feel, your brain recognizes that you're not really in danger. So you get that natural high without the risk. Yeah, I guess that's true, huh? Personally, I'm not super into like scary movies and haunted houses and stuff like that. I'm totally down for doing some, you know, some, I guess, adventurous stuff. Like, I'd go like skydiving and stuff like that. But I don't know, I've never been super into like scary stuff. It's not like it's like too scary for me. It's just I'm not really into it. Catching a yawn could help us bond. Let's see. So they have a few theories as to why yawning is contagious. The leading one says it's empathy. So people who are less likely to show empathy, such as toddlers who haven't learned it yet, or young people with autism, are also less likely to yawn in reaction to someone else's. Interesting. We care more about a single person than about massive tragedies. Yeah, that's something you see all around in like movies and video games and stuff like that. Yeah, it's just what we do, you know. Especially if you're really close to that one person, then it's like, you know, beginnings and ends are easier to remember than middles. So it said when people are asked to recall items from a list, they're most likely to think of things from the very end or from the very beginning. That's kind of cool. Interesting. It takes five positive things to outweigh a single negative thing. I don't know if that's 100% true. I don't know if it's exactly, you know, five positive stuff, a lot more than the good stuff. But I think that's just kind of the typical human behavior. But honestly, I think we can kind of like fall out of that. So, I would say doing attitude, gratitude, personal affirmations, success journals, kind of stuff like that. Just things that you have that kind of keep putting things in your head, all those good things in your head consistently. Helps us that when those bad things do kind of come around, it's like, yeah, it's bad, but it's not that bad. There's a lot of good stuff too. So food tastes better when someone else makes it. So they say, when you make yourself a meal, you're around it so long that it feels less exciting by the time you actually dig in. So it decreases your enjoyment. Okay. I guess so. So I guess it's saying that food that you don't have to work for, tastes better. Boils down to. We'd rather know something bad is coming than not know what to expect. Yes, that, okay, this is me. one of the things I dislike about the army is, there's a lot of uncertainty, especially with like regulations and stuff. A lot of the time, especially for the smaller stuff, a lot of it resides under commander's discretion. So pretty much whatever the commander wants to do. So much of it is just uncertainty. Ourselves. head when we read aloud, or our brains also talk over boring speeches. If someone is speaking monotonously, we'll subconsciously make it more vivid in our heads. Alright. Some people enjoy seeing anger in others. We automatically second guess ourselves when other people disagree. Yeah, I could definitely say that. We aren't as good at multitasking as we think we are. Or feel like you're in a bad position.